There's little worse than getting a malware infection or virus on your PC, and there are two main ways of getting infected. The first is by visiting an infected website. The second is by opening an infected email. In this short video, we're going to look at the second, how to protect yourself from an infected email. The first step is actually to change your thinking. If you're thinking, "I want to prevent my computer from being attacked," you've got it wrong. Because if you ever think your computer is protected, you'll relax, and that's when you'll get hit. In today's world, malware attacks are sophisticated, silent, and inevitable. You will be attacked, and you can never afford to relax. So it's much better to think, how can I reduce my vulnerability to an attack? You need two things. The first is a firewall. This is software that only allows your computer to connect to trusted sources. It blocks all the rest. Setting up a firewall properly is complicated, so most firewalls have generic settings. The firewall that comes with Windows 10 is a good example. It's basic, but it works. But even trusted sources can transmit malware. An infected email is a good example. So you also need antivirus protection. However, the kind of antivirus protection you can buy off the shelf works by checking incoming data against a remote database of known threats and has two major weaknesses. The database must be current, and the software must be able to detect the threat. So, the best possible protection is to use a managed antivirus service. Make sure that you have the best antivirus protection on your workstations and your servers. If you're in any doubt at all, contact the techs at eTop Technology. But an infected email can get through your firewall because the firewall allows connections to your email provider. And it may bypass your antivirus software. So let's have a look at a real-life example of a suspicious email. Here's one from my inbox. The first warning signal is the address. Now, I've never heard of vizilit.com. And it's a strange-sounding name. And the second warning signal is the subject. Re-invoice. It's a very vague title. It's designed either to worry me or to interest me, because money is involved. But the third warning signal is the attachment. You may be asked to open an attachment in order either to avoid a negative consequence or to gain something valuable. But by doing so, you can execute a hidden routine that will place malware on your machine. The golden rule is never click on an attachment unless you're 100% certain that it's safe. These three warning signals together would make me delete that email immediately, and you should do the same. But for training purposes, let's open it. Well, the content certainly confirms my suspicions. Firstly, the grammar's wrong. C should not have a capital letter. It's either a receipt or an invoice, it can't be both. And wrong transfer? That should be incorrect transfer. And I've never heard of HDFC Bank, which is very different from vizilla.com. So let's go even one step further and allow Outlook to show us the attachment. It says it's a PDF, but I suspect otherwise. Let's look at it online. I don't have to download it, so that's reasonably safe on my Mac. Aha! Just as I suspected, it's not a PDF. It's a Word document, which is possibly one of the most risky formats to download. There'll almost certainly be a macro hidden in that Word document somewhere that would have placed malware on my machine if I'd downloaded it. It could be a virus, a keylogger, spyware, or adware, but whatever it is, I don't want it on my machine. Follow the red flag signs. If there's an address you don't recognize, with a vague subject that's about money, risk, or gain, and it has an attachment or a link you don't recognize, delete it immediately. And if you think you have a virus, call the techs at eTop Technology. We're here to help. If you like these videos, please visit our channel for more helpful how-tos and subscribe.